Your work always tells a story. Let's have a close look.
Hello, welcome to Close Look. I'm Daniel Wespe, and I'm joined today with Leo. Hey, Leo, how you doing?
Living the dream. Yeah. That's pretty good.
Let's talk about that dream. You came here to Canada, so why come here?
Well, that's a very good question. I came to Canada my first time in 2009. I took high school in Nanaimo. So it was my first Canadian experience. And since then, I was planning to come back. And I come back with my wife in 2014 to the Canadian dream.
You came to Canada to start this. So what, when you came back to Canada, did you already have the vision to want to start your own business? Or was this something that just happened when you got here?
So actually, since I was 6 years old, I always liked to be entrepreneur. My father was entrepreneur, and I didn't see myself working forever for someone else. Of course, we always have to start at some point working for someone else to pay our bills, right? Aaron Nightingale said that if you are working for someone else, but you know where you want to be, you are a successful. Success, it's not based on how much money you have. It's about if you know what you want from your life. So when I come to Canada, I had to work. I work in the kitchen. I work selling hot dogs, chicken wraps. So I start like everybody else, right? I was proud. So I believe if you are moving to another country, you have to be very humility. And then I was to find an opportunity to open my own business. And in 2016, I started planning to open a business. My wife and I didn't have our permanent residence. Our friends called us like, oh, you are crazy. You're gonna go bankruptcy. But I believe if you have a dream, that's all you need. You need a dream and a decision. If you have those, doesn't matter if you have the knowledge, doesn't matter if you know the people, and doesn't matter if you have the money. These are not important. The only thing important that I always tell my audience, it's you have to have a dream.
Those are very strong words, because you do talk about humility. Oh man, that's a hard word to say.
It isn't.
And I think that's really important in this day and age. A lot of millennials, people coming up, they don't want to take the punches. They just want the success. And I think that that's fantastic to say to everybody, because it is. You need to take those. That's what creates character. Now, I did hear, and I mean, I heard you talking to Simi off screen, that you do read a lot of books. She told me about it. And you were quoting a lot of books. So is that kind of your inspiration to this? Like, is that what pushed you to change all these philosophers, all these influential people over the generation, decades even? And is that what inspired Leonardo? The name, I mean, that's a painter, but I mean, still an influencer.
Well, it's funny because I start read a lot of books when I was 25 to 26 years old. Before that, I just read two or three books because I was obligated by schools. What took the shift in my life was because I need to change. I had the desire, the internal desire to be better, not for myself, not for only my family, but for the community in overall. Erm Buffel, he always say, you cannot get 9 women pregnant and expect a baby in a month. You have to wait for 9 months, right? So this, the message that I want to take to everyone that it's in the age between 18 to 30, it's everything needs their own time. It's like a tree. We are surrounded here by tree. Tree doesn't grow immediately. Tree grows first underground to create very strong, solid and deep roots, and then go up. Why? Because in this manner, if we have some storm, the trees can stand still. So you need the foundation. You need to be patient. I was very anxious person, and the books helped me to figure it out about myself. Bob Proctor always say, if you know you, you know everything, right? But first of all, you have to understand who you are. A lot of people try to understand somebody else. A lot of people like get in pain. Oh, they don't understand me. They don't understand me. It's their mistake. You have to understand you. And the reason why I start to read, it's not because I love, it's because I have to. So if you have to do something, you have to pay the price. That is a universal law called law of gestation and law of sacrifice. Nowadays, a lot of people are expecting a magical button that you press and everything is happen. So I will press this, I will start my business, I will be a millionaire in a month, in a year. Sorry, doesn't work like that. You can be whatever you want in your life, however, you have to pay the price. While your friends are at a club, party, and barbecue, you are reading, you are studying. The thing is, they're gonna call you crazy, maybe you're gonna lose some friendships. However, in 5 to 10 years, you're gonna be living their dream, right?
That's so strong, so defiant. So we're speaking of passion and things that you are doing, and I don't think we touched on that. So what it is that you do? You read just books all day or no?
Oh, you know, I wish. I remember in 2016 when I started like this personal development program with myself, right? I used to read like 4 books a month. Today I can't. I will tell you why. It's not because I'm busier. Actually, I'm a little busier, but it's not because of that. Because once you start to understand what the books are telling you, it's so much profound, and I have to come back and read over and over and over to really get the essence. Because you can read in a book, you can be whatever you want in your life, because your outside world, it's a reflection of your inside world. You can go and pass through that and go to the next phrase. However, the message here is much deeper. Our external world, it's mere a reflection of our inside world, which means that whatever we think, we're gonna experience in the world. So the reason why I became a slow reader, it's because I became a student of the books. Now I am studying, I'm not just reading. In the beginning, I thought as much book I read, I'll be smarter. But the thing is, after the book, I was thinking like, what did I understand? Nothing. Because I was like, read, 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 read. That's what I tell my wife, I tell every single one. Don't read a lot of books. Understand, be a study, be a student, not a follower. That's one of the Jim Rohn's quotes. Be a student, not a follower.
I do agree with that. I feel like there's a lot of, with anything really, film and books and music, I feel like there's always that undertone that people do need to reflect on and look at. I agree with that. So what is it that you're hoping to build, and what is it that you're hoping to achieve moving forward, and what is the vision of Leonardo?
My vision is if I could contribute to the community, to the planet, as Jim Rohn did. So I found about Jim Rohn in 2018. He is my hero. He has the way he says complex things in a simple way. He was telling, I was listening to one of his videos about the ant philosophy. So the ant philosophy works like that. Ant never quit. So if you block, if you see a lot of ants, they are going one path. If you block their path, they're not gonna quit. They will go around. So why human beings, we are much advanced species, right? And we quit. That is a phrase that says that a winner never quit and a quitter never wins. So the thing that we have to do is never quit. Another thing very interesting that I learned with Jim Rohn. How tall a tree grows? Tree grows in their max capacity. How come human beings don't grow in their max capacity? It's a very simple answer, very simple. Because they gave us the power of thinking and choose our own environment. That's why human beings are the only species in the planet that doesn't feel comfortable in our environment, because we have the ability to make our own environment.
Now, Leonardo, with all your dreams, aspirations, everything, I'm gonna get a little deep here with you, all right? Trust me, it's not too deep, but your parents, it's always that question of, did your parents want you to do this? Did you defy your parents? Do they hate you now? I know it's a strong word, hate's a strong word. But what is the, what's the status with your parents? Did they accept you for wanting to do this or pursue this?
You know, that's a very fantastic question. I'm very glad you helped, because all entrepreneurs have the same struggle, the acceptance of our family. Our family accept what we want to do. I figured it out by my own experience. When my parents, especially my mom, because my father was an entrepreneur, my mom used to say, you have to go to university. And just let me very clear, I didn't go to university. There is nothing wrong with university. There is nothing wrong, you can learn a lot of things, but something you're never gonna learn in university, it's the experience. Experience, it's here, right? So, my parents, they always support me. However, my mom always said, you have to have a plan B. The thing is, when your parent tells you, go to school, doesn't mean that they don't trust in you. Mean that they care, they love you, and they don't want you to get hurt. There is a phrase in a Napoleon Hill book about Plan B. I'm not gonna quote very the way that was.
No, you can read the whole chapter if you want. Just say the whole chapter.
Okay, so he was like telling something about Plan B. He said that a group of soldiers went to another country to fight a war. But he was very small group. So they were around, they said like 300. And the other team was like a 5,000, something like that. It was like a huge difference. And the 5,000 was making the war at home, and the 300 came from other country. They said that once they landed at the shore, the captain said, put a fire on our boats. Put a fire in the boats, and the fire in the boats got in fire. So the captain say, gentlemen, now we are here in this country and there is no plan B. Or we win or we die. And seriously, this is not a joke at all. This is a very strong and powerful teaching that I learned. If you don't have a plan B, you will make work. I know plan B sometimes it's okay, but in the business world, plan B gives you an option of exiting. If you have an help, if you have an exit option, you're not gonna give everything of yourself, because the soldiers didn't have another option unless they won. They did the best they could. So what I tell everyone, do the best you can. Do the best you can, do what you can. Doesn't blame your family, doesn't blame the community, doesn't blame the government. So we have to do our best, and the parents, they want to support us, but they don't want us to get hurt. So say, mom, dad, I love you, but this is my dream. If you could support me, if you could help me, that's what I want for my life.
Wow. So they support you?
Yes, they support me, but my mom, I'm 28 years old, and my mom like call me, hey son, you have like to get a plan B in university, just get a graduation. I was like, okay mom, I will. But there is nothing wrong, you know? There is some people that study the leaves, there is some people that studies the roots. So there is people who likes to work for somebody else, there is nothing wrong, right? And there are other people that like to build their business and employ them, right? That is, again, nothing wrong. It's just your personality. You have to figure it out, your personality. That's why earlier I said you have to study you. You have to see like how you like to act. How do you really are? You can lie to every single one except to the reflection on the mirror.
So your parents are in full support. I see your lovely, I'm going to say wife.
Oh,
you
yeah.
said wife, yes. 100%. Wife is off screen here, but she is in total support also, right? Like, I mean, you guys are together. You guys seem really happy. So clearly she is happy with whatever it is that you're doing. And it totally is behind you 100%. And I think that's really cool. So, yeah.
Okay. Just let me tell about the Will Smith first. The Will Smith got success because he pays the price. While he was studying in acting, in personal development, his friends was partying. So, Albert Einstein says, what's insanity? If you do the same thing over and over and over and expect different results, you are insanity. So that's what people, most of the people are. They do the same thing, they party, they go, they don't pay the price, and they want a success. So don't fake out, right? You have to pay the price. That's one of the universal law of sacrifice. You must, you have, you ought pay the price. Regarding my wife, that's a very incredible question. So what I'm gonna say, it's true, okay? I'm not saying because she's here, because it is true. Whatever I am, whatever I have today, it's because of her. Let me tell why. In 2012, when I met her, I was a completely different person. I always got my dreams, but I was little... The way that I treat her was different. So I always treat her good, but the thing is, with my study, with my books, I understood how we should treat better our wife. You know, I was little, say like, oh, you don't go there, you have to go with me, you know, it was wrong.
Yeah.
And I say to all my friends that she is the best investor ever, because to invest in a stock market, you have to have patience, you have to have the vision, you have to see in a 5-10 years. So what she saw in me in 2012 was, who am I getting today? So I am the starting point when she saw me 6 years ago, because I would say she's the best investor ever, because now she start to collect the dividends, I would say. Seriously, now she start collecting the dividends, because back then, oh, trust me, I was very nice. I always helped people, but the way I treat, I was very, not conservative, but I was very like, I don't know the English word for that. I was like, if you want to go with your friends, I have to go with you. You cannot go by yourself. Huh?
Controlling.
Yes, that's the words. I was very controlling, and this was making terrible feelings, and I wasn't seeing, but she was seeing. So we came in a point that, or I change, or we have to split up. So I put in a balance. I was like, what the heck? I'm not going to split up. I must to change. So that's when I start changing myself, because if you change, the things will change for you. That's the key. You have to change.
Overall, everything that you said, it is very self-reflective. You're very, change. Totally, you need to change. It's part of evolution.
Yes.
And I don't know why, yeah, I agree with you 100%. People seem to have a trouble with wanting that change, because you're right, they do get comfortable. 9 to 5 is really easy. You get up, you go do something, sometimes you just gotta break the mold. And it seems like you did. You're wearing the same shirt as me, but making it look better. I get it, it's okay. So, you talk about seeing a future that she saw what you saw, or see in you now. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Do you guys share a vision as to where you see yourself in 5 years? Where you guys see each other in 5 years?
Yes. I believe the base of any relationship is trust, and you have to share. So if you have one vision and your wife has other vision, or your husband has other vision, and it's a completely opposite vision, the chance you will stay with that person, it's almost zero. Why? Let's say you want to have 5 kids. Your wife doesn't want to have kids at all, and not even adopt.
Yeah.
So you have a problem, huge problem. So our plans are the same. What I want to do, it's what Jim Rohn did for the earth, for the planet, for the people. Help and make every single one of you understand your power. We have a power, but we don't understand we have this power. Seriously, it's so clear. But it's like you say, oh, it's clear for you, not clear for me. It's not true. The thing is, how am I able to play a piano if I just practice once a day per month?
Yeah.
So I just practice one time a day a month. So in 30 days, I just practice one time. You're never gonna learn. You have to continue practice every single day to get in a point of understanding. And trust me, I have lots. I have a tons of materials to learn, okay? I would say I am in my 1% capacity. Whatever I said now, it's just 1% of the whole thing, right? So I believe you have to surround yourself with smart people. I believe if you are the smart people in a room, you are missing the boat. You are missing, especially in business, right? Like, I am the best one in my business. So why you hire your lawyer? Why did you hire your executive if you are the smartest one? You can do everything. You have to know little of everything, but not everything of everything, you know, just like it's small. And I believe if you have the humility to say, I don't know, it's good. You have to show that. You have to be more human. We are in the 21st century. we are not like connected. We are every time on the phone. The couple are dating. She's on the phone. The guy is on the phone. They are texting each other. It's wrong. So I believe you have like to start improving yourself, because if you change, your environment change as well. It's automatically. Because let's say you have a vice, I don't know, you drink too much, okay? You're gonna hang out with fellows that drinks, because that's what you feel comfortable. If I read, you drink, you're not gonna feel comfortable with me, and I'm not gonna feel comfortable with you. Doesn't mean you are a bad person. Means that we share of different visions. So that's why I said with your partner, you have to have almost the same vision, not opposite, but sometimes you learn with each other, right? I learn with her every single day. Every single day. And she has the patience to listen to me. Not a lot of people has it. Yeah. She does. She does. She's good. She stopped everything what she's doing to listen to me. And sometimes when she talks to me, I'm on the phone, I'm like, awareness. Mm-hmm. Awareness. I believe that is a quote that says, to escape of a prison, you have first to realize you are in a prison. So to figure it out, you have to change. You have to be aware that you have to change. So I believe the awareness is one of the key, right? Like the success, you don't bake a cake with one ingredient. You don't do like a chocolate cake with chocolate. You need a lot of ingredients in exactly certain amounts, right? So for success, it's exactly the same thing. You need a lot of ingredients.
I think what I like about what you're saying here is, because I think the one term that I do hate, and whenever somebody comes up to me, they're like, it is what it is. I hate this term. It doesn't make sense to me, because like you, my mind is just, there's so many ways that things can go, and you're just trying to figure, you're trying to just go forward, but then you get people that are like, that's life. You know, it's done. You know, that's what it is. So how do you feel about those? Like, obviously you cut off everybody, and I agree with that. You cut off everybody that's negative in your life, but you still must come across people that are negative. What do you like? What's your response? I'm going to get deep here.
I love it.
And so what's your response to the naysayers, to the people who don't believe that what you are doing is going to get you anywhere, even if all the proof is clearly not in their favor? So I'm just curious, what's your response to all that?
It's good, because this topic alone we can discuss for 2 hours. So, but let's get started with your first question.
Yeah. Okay.
So the thing is, when I started studying personal development, I was so excited to share. And it's like you are telling people, if you do this, you change your life. And it's look like that is a glass. They're not hearing you. They say, hey, did you watch the game last night? I was like, listen, I'm telling you something. So Jesus said, don't throw your pearls to the pigs, which means that don't waste your energy to those who doesn't want help. You have to help those who wants help, and those who help themselves first. And regarding the other subject that we discussed, it's what was the first thing you said was
I said the naysayers, like, it is what it is.
Oh, it is what
it
is. Thank you, perfect. Okay. So the thing is, it is what it is. A lot of people say that. I used to say that, okay. I belong to that group before. It is what it is. What most, not all, most of the medias, they want to put in your mind a programming, okay, that you don't have the power, you don't have the energy to change. Why? Let me tell you why. If the TV tells you, oh, the world, it's almost in the third war. The world, it's bad. The world is that. You have an excuse to tell yourself, see, that's why I don't invest in myself. That's why I don't open my business. That's why I don't do this. That's so they want to control you to feel comfortable, to take your power of you. They want to put in your mind that you don't have the power to change. Because if you believe the fault of whatever is happening in your life, it's from someone else outside you, you don't have the power to change. That's what most of the media are trying and are implanting for the past 50 years. They are putting in your mind, they are seeding, and they are watering every single day through medias that you don't have the power to change. If you don't have the power to change, how I'm gonna change? The answer is when you change. So that's what I started learning. If I change, things will change. Not everybody will understand, will accept, will believe. But the thing is, where you're going to be in the next 5 years compared to the person that says that this, it's a BS. They say that good people, you don't make good people. You lap date good people because they're already good. It's like a diamond. Diamonds are already good. You just have to lap date, right? So good people, you don't have to try to make them good unless they are already good. So it's a topic that I love to discuss about it, and it's there are a lot of materials which I had to go through to start grasping the surface. I tell everyone, I'm just grasping the surface. I didn't go deep enough, right? So that's the essence of life. To things to change, you must change.